Elie Seckbach. You're watching one of the best fighters in boxing, Vergil Ortiz, 100% knockout ratio. He's working very hard right now with Coach Hector Beltran, his father and brother over here, Vergil Sr. and X-Man Joe. Is it a Jose or Joe?
Joe.
Is it Joseph or Joe?
No, it's Joe. It's just Joe.
Is that a real name?
Yeah.
Virgilio is a real Mexican name.
Virgilio.
Virgilio. Joe is a very American name.
His name was... Technically, it was supposed to be Jose, but
okay.
I named him after my grandpa. I always knew my grandpa was Joe Ortiz, and when he passed away, I named him after my grandpa. But
same name?
I didn't know my grandpa's real name was Jose. My grandpa thought it was Joe.
As you can see, Vergil is a very, very hard-hitting puncher. Even though he fights at 147 of the ring, he spars people 160 and up. He's already going 25 rounds today. And this is him after sparring, after all the work. When Jose Ramirez became the unified champ, they asked him about what it's like to spar Vergil Ortiz. He said, I spar Manny Pacquiao, and Vergil Ortiz is an animal. But he didn't specify which animal. He may be a liger. Half tiger, half lion. Lion, tiger. Rounds in, going like round one to round 26.
No.
One more round. How hard does he hit?
Or,
no, like what? Like what does it feel like?
Sometimes I can feel it here, like pushing back.
Or if I don't hold my hook in,
uh-huh.
I feel like the bone kind of.
What happens if he misses once and lands one on your chin or your stomach?
He's hit me before.
He hit me like recently, remember? On the chin?
And what happened?
It feels like a, like the noise goes, and here it's real weird in it. Your jaw feels like it moves.
Do your legs get shaky afterwards? Like
no, because it, like actually, what I do is when he throws, I pull a little bit just to help,
just
me,
in case.
And I kind of absorb it a little bit. But yeah, he's cutting before.
You do it on purpose or by mistake?
Nah, it's always on accident.
No, I'm joking.
I used to have a 7-year-old trainer. I used to hit his glasses off. Problem?
Oh.
You know, one time I was doing mid setting. And when you guys don't do this with you guys, I was like, all right, you know, one, two, hook. And then it was high. And I was high. And I'm not even bullshit. I literally went like this, and the motherfucker throws a jab, and he fucking hits me.
Oh, Jay?
Remember?
I was Jay.
I was sweating, and I wiped my forehead, and he
fucking. What happened?
He fucking hit me. I'm like, what the fuck?
Did he drop you?
No, but he hit my head.
Did you get mad?
I told him, what the fuck's wrong with you, man? I fucking told him to put your hands down and I slapped him.
Did he learn from that? Never did it again?
Nah, he's more than cautious now.
But it's hard to train people who never box. So you know what to expect. They don't control the power. And I notice with beginners, every punch they want a haymaker.
Yeah.
They want really power. They don't accept it. Boxing is a sport. It's technique. It's endurance. What do you think your son's secret of power is? Technique, power, God-given DNA?
That really is more than he's been throwing his punches right since he was kid? You
like the Russian fighters, they just learn very well and...
Well, not only learn very well, but he works so hard onto landing the punch at the right time, as in distance-wise, that we always make sure, even if he was in a fight, you know, some people go and do these little quick punches and then move. I never let him get into that rhythm because... That might give you a little win there, a little win battle there. It might even win you a little amateur fight. And if you're too busy trying to win those kind of fights, then that's how you'll always fight.
So we like, just throw with a bad intention.
Yeah, we just pretty much stick to the game plan. And when I trained him as a little boy, I trained him to pretty much this way. Is consistency. Be consistent.
For those who don't know, what was Vergil Ortiz's amateur record?
His amateur record, I know they say it's 140 and 20, but he was in the 60s with only, it might have been like in the older, like in the high teens, but a lot of those losses were when he was a little kid, like starting 8 and 10, because there was a time he didn't lose for like 3 years.
That's crazy.
Like hardly, in the amateurs, it's hard in the amateurs.
You fight every weekend. You fight, so how many fights do you think he won without losing in one stretch?
Man, I don't know.
Because you get robbed a lot of amateurs. Not you, but people. I've been in a lot of fights where the grandfather is the ref of the grandson. The grandson gets his ass whooped, dropped 6 times, and the grandson still wins.
And remember this, then you're still going to nationals, you're still leading.
Against the famous guys.
So
3 years without a loss, how many national titles did he win?
7.
So the overall record was 120 and 20, something like that? 140 and 20?
Overall, it's probably like 160 something, and maybe 18.
Wow. And those 18, not all of them. Many of them came early.
Yeah, they came when he was a little kid, like little kid.
It almost sucks that it's still on the record. If you lost when you were 7.
It's all right.
It's okay. How did it feel to go 3 years without a loss?
It felt good. I felt like I could feel when people wanted to watch me. Can you tell my shoes? Like people wanted to watch me fight and all that. I think I let it get to my head a little bit.
It's okay. It's a good life lesson. Good life lesson.
That's why I'm not like that anymore.
Yeah, now you're just cool, whether you're 13-0 or 50-0 or...
When I had lost again, man, it devastated me.
But it didn't break you.
I could have won. Murdered that guy.
Yeah.
What happened?
I won't get into detail, but I just didn't listen.
Okay, it happens.
And he still lost a close fight.
Yeah, it was a close fight.
But what I'm saying is, Vergil, look, you're like bamboo. You bend and not break. Like, it happens. Losses happen. It's part of life. You don't hold on to them. You don't, like, dwell over it. You let it go and move on to the next. Mm-hmm. The worst thing you could do is, when a fighter has a draw with someone, where they force them to fight again. It's okay. Let it go. Move on to the next. Don't prove anything to nobody.
But his thing was, he just got over too confident and... Even the punches that didn't hurt, he still didn't realize that.
Yeah,
there's still little points.
But it's okay. It's
just touching. No, I know, but that's what he has to learn, and that's what he did learn. So, but in the pros, it's different. The little touchy stuff, that shit don't count.
No.
It's about really hitting somebody.
Finishing.
Yeah, you gotta finish. I've been looking at it on Instagram. So
there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.